The aim of this video is to introduce you to Moodle for your eChannel Moodle course.
Although what you see in this video may not be exactly what you will experience in your course, you will learn how to get around a typical Moodle environment and see some common activities and tools.
You will have received a Moodle user ID and password from your eChannel course provider. Go to the provided URL to log in and enter that information. This takes you to your Moodle dashboard.
The Moodle dashboard shows a timeline where you can easily see what you need to do in your courses and when they are due. You can use the links to go directly to each activity or assignment. There is also a convenient calendar that lists all of your course events. In the block drawer on the right side is a list of your recently accessed items, making it easy for you to pick up where you left off each time you log into Moodle. This upper area of the Moodle interface or screen will always be present no matter where you are. It contains a link back to your eChannel course provider, a home link that takes you to the Moodle front page, a link back to this dashboard page, and a link to an overview of your courses. From the right side, you can toggle a notifications menu, your messaging drawer, and access your personal profile settings. The My Courses page shows an overview of all the courses in which you are enrolled, with an indication of your progress in each one. To enter a course, click on its name. When you access a page for the first time, a user tour may pop up that will guide you through various areas of Moodle. If at any time you would like to see a tour again, click on the question mark at the bottom right of the page and select Reset User Tour. This is also where you can access support from your Moodle provider. On the left of the course page is the course index, showing all of the sections and the various activities in each. The main part of this page displays the course content. To free up space, you can collapse sections in either the main area or in the course index. You can also collapse all sections and then only open the section on which you wish to focus. To make room for more visible content, collapse the course index by clicking the X. To open it again at any time, click the menu icon. On the right side, there may be additional information in what is called the block drawer. To hide the information, click the X. To open the block drawer again, click on the arrow. If a course completion status block is present, you will be able to track your progress through the course. Other blocks of information may also be provided by your instructor, and blocks may be arranged differently from what you see here in this sample course. Course content will typically be presented in sections, either weekly or by topic. Each section contains a variety of activities and resources for you to complete. Click on the title to view the information and instructions. At any time, you can go back to the main page of the course by clicking on its name in the breadcrumb trail at the top of the course content. Completion requirements will be shown on the right of each activity. In some cases, you can mark these as done manually. Otherwise, the status will be indicated in green upon completion. Notice that when an activity is completed, it will also be indicated in the course index with a green dot. There are many types of activities and resources that your instructor may include in your eChannel Moodle course, and in this video, we will feature some of the more common ones.
Lesson material can be presented as a single page of information or as a book of several pages. To see the content, click on the title link and then read through the information that is presented. The content may include images, videos, or links, and you may have to scroll down to get to the end.
When you have completed the page, use the course index to continue on to the next activity. Or you can use the breadcrumb trail to return to the course content. Pages of lessons are often combined into a book format. When you open a book, a table of contents will be found in the block drawer on the right side. You can navigate within the book using the links in this table of contents, or use the Next and Previous buttons at the end of each chapter to go forward and back within the book before proceeding to the next activity in the section or topic. Use the More menu to print a PDF version of either the entire book or a single chapter. A forum or discussion allows instructors and learners to exchange ideas and answer specific questions by posting comments within a thread or topic. Your instructor may include text, images, or videos to review prior to posting. The choice activity, often used for quick surveys or polls, presents a question with a number of answers from which to choose. Your instructor will determine whether or not to publish poll results within the session. Assignments allow you to submit your work for grading. Your instructor will include directions for what is required in the assignment and for submitting it. You may be required to enter text directly in a provided Moodle space, or you may be asked to submit or upload a file. Your instructor may also include quiz activities. Quizzes can include several types of questions, including multiple choice, true or false, fill in the blanks, and matching questions. Instructors may link to internet or web pages using the URL resource. Sometimes these web links will open up within the Moodle main block, or they may open in a separate window that you should close when you are finished viewing. You may see additional activities or resources in your Moodle course. For example, H5P content is often used to provide even more interactivity. There may also be live sessions, office hours, or group activities that you can join directly from your Moodle course using the big blue button Virtual Meeting Room.
Regardless of the type of activity or resource, simply click on the title and then follow the on-screen instructions provided by your instructor.
This video has covered basic Moodle features and commonly used resources and activities. Please contact your online mentor, your instructor, if you have any trouble with your eChannel Moodle course.